Why do we always feel like we need to try? Why do we believe that we need to be somebody else to feel alive? Why do we make? Why do we keep making the same mistakes? And believing that it won't make a difference if we try to break away.
Losing him. Oh, hello. Welcome in, everybody. I hope we're all having a beverage. I'm having a beverage. I'm having a boozy peppermint milkshake. So who knows where things are going to go? This could all go off the rails, but we're here. Hello. Welcome in, Helios. Good to see you. Oh, I got it in my chapstick. Which, what are we feeling today? I have peppermint, so maybe staying with a mint theme. That's what we'll do. We'll stick with a mint theme, so we stay on brand. Tetra, how are you? Yes, it's Ollie Alexander will be the UK's entry to Eurovision. They want to win, and it shows. Listen, after they got a little taste of, they got close with, once they got close with, what's his face? Sam Ryder. Although I have to say, I did not care for that song, actually. So I don't even think they should have been close to winning. But once they got a little taste and they realized, oh, we could win. It's not out of the, you know, there isn't this, like, inability for them to win like there is with, say, Ireland. Now, I don't want to accuse anyone of anything. It just feels like it doesn't matter what Ireland send. They're never going to do well anymore. I can't do mint flavor. Most of the time, it tastes like toothpaste. I can assure you, Helios, this does not taste like toothpaste. It's great. You know who's happy I'm streaming today? Kelly. Because She's like, I never have time to wrap presents. And I was like, well, Brady's at work and I'm going to be streaming. I was like, take this time, wrap the presents. So she's literally, as soon as I started, she's going into like wrapping madness. So I have to, if I need a drink or something, I'm going to have to, like, stick my head out and announce, like, I'm walking out. Hide anything you need to. Kelly's present just arrived, yesterday. Do you want to see what it is? Hold on. I'm also not going to be able to talk about it much. I don't want her to hear, but I'll show it. Let me grab it. Did I say on stream at some point what we were getting? Oh, did my camera get bumped? Hold on. Why can you see my room? I think my camera got bumped or something. Did I do that? I might have done that. What's that? Is that the mic? That's the mic. Okay, we're back to good. Back to all set. I was like, ooh, that's the corner of my room. Don't look at that. I mean, it was just the door of my closet. But this, you don't think she's lurking? Kelly, watch one of my streams. That'll be the fucking day. We got her this. Because she needs one. A new one. And so this is what my idea. I'm taking full credit for it. I've made it very clear that this was my idea. But Brady and Chase got in on it with me. Because I was like, she always has been. She has one of those, but it's old. And I was like, we need a new one. So I've had that idea for months. So what do we think? Good, bad? I think it's good. No, I think it's good. I think it's good. I think she'll like it. And I think she'll be like, oh, yeah. Like, you know, I stand by it. How's everybody doing? Helios, she doesn't really use that. Honest to God, she doesn't use that often. She prefers the version that's like the one I showed you. Why? I don't know. I couldn't explain to you, but I've said too much. I need to stop. I have not finished all of my shopping. I need to go get Brady's presents still, but I know what I'm getting, and it's easy, and it's something I can go and grab quite quickly, and it's just a gift card, but it's a gift card to like a food place that he goes like constantly, like probably a good at least once a week. So I'm like, well, if ever I was going to get, you know, if ever there was a time to get someone a gift card to somewhere, I'm like, this makes a lot of sense because he's here literally constantly. So I'm like, okay, let's get him a gift card to here. And it's not, I can go grab it like pretty quickly after work. I just have to do that at some point. And then I bought something for Dave. I had this like vision in my head and I was like, can I execute this? And then I found it online pretty exactly as I pictured. And I was like, yes. So, but oh my God. So Kelly and I ordered it on Amazon. Like, I want to say like Tuesday, Wednesday, maybe. And I was like, it's Amazon, you know, it'll be here in a few days. It'll be good. It was like, we promise it'll be here before Christmas, but it'll be like the day or two before Christmas. I said, excuse me? She was like, yeah, welcome to what? She was like, you wonder why I say like, no, you can't add random stuff to your Christmas list in like the days leading up to Christmas. She's like, because like I would now still be adding things I thought of. She's like, no. The delivery times on everything, like, jack up to, like, 2 weeks, even with Prime. And I was like, So it says it'll be here in time, but I already gave him the warning of, like, I'm like, it'll very probably be here on time. I can't make a 100% promise. So we'll see. It should be fine. It should be fine, but yeah, there's that lingering thing of I'm like, oh my God, I told you to order weeks ago. Well, hi, Maple. Maple, I miss the entrance sound for you. I need to come up with something else, but I did feel very clever for the one I came up with. Oh, everybody's at an ad break right now. But then guess what? Then there's no pre-roll for like 30 minutes. So that's okay. We're just chatting. What are we doing today? We're doing the finale of Lake. What is going on out there? There's like dark chemtrails in the sky. People must be doing like plain stuff. What are you drinking? This is a boozy peppermint milkshake. Boozy peppermint milkshake. It's very good. Helios thinks it's toothpaste. I say, is your toothpaste alcohol-y? Because that tastes alcohol-y. So we'll see. Boozies, that's smart. Well, I am about to drive a mail truck, so we'll see. Because, you know, you're not really supposed to do that. Oh my God. Is that the icon, Pisces, please? Pi, how are you? Let me shout out, y'all. If you're not following the icon, the legend... Please do. Pi, have you seen what's coming to all... Stop. Why is all I can think coming to the tree? I'm too Hunger Games coded. Are you coming to the tree? What's coming to... What am I thinking of? Eviction notice, Roblox Big Brother. There we go. Put it together. Took me a second to try and think of what the hell I was trying to say. Let's pull it up. Let's pull it up. Okay. Coming to eviction notice is... which button do I need to click? I'm putting it on. Just stop. Are they finally updating? Apparently the biggest update ever is coming. The biggest update ever. It's less than a week away, and there's a new game mode called Assassin. In this mode, a player will be secretly named as an assassin. The assassin must try to blend in with the other players while making some tough decisions. Eat. We're gonna pretend that didn't happen. Each round, the assassin must choose a player or players to receive strikes. These strikes are votes against you if you find yourself facing eviction. You do not want these. They can also build up over time if you continue to receive them. Most importantly, if the assassin makes it to the final three, they instantly win. How do you catch this assassin? Stay tuned for another post. Exciting. Listen, in all the time I've been playing Eviction Notice, there hasn't been a new game mode since then, and there hasn't really been many updates, so I'm excited for this. I hope there's a lot more challenges and stuff, but, Addie, would you strike me? Maple, I don't know, Maple, would that make people think I was the assassin or wasn't the assassin? I think I'd make a good assassin. It's almost a tiny bit giving, what's the game with the guns and the dark at the table? Breaking Point. It's almost kind of giving Breaking Point. One of the modes is one person is the killer and you have to vote out the killer. It's almost giving The Traitors too. But that's the new mode. I can't wait for it never to get voted for. Because you know the children do be voting for duos. Every time. It's impossible to get another mode to happen. But Pi and I one time played a very long and very messy game of Eviction Notice with Isaaco. I'm like, can you imagine if there had been an assassin in the mode too? It was chaos. It was the largest jury I've ever seen. I think there were like 7 or 8 people in the jury. We were literally all sitting in the audience doing nothing but just talking mad shit. We were all so bitter. We were dragging the girls still in the game. It was so fucking funny. I'm so freaking excited. I'm excited. And the house, have you seen the pictures of the house? Because the pictures of the house came out like a while ago. It's gorgeous. It's like Victorian. It's everything. Look at this. It's beautiful. And they did say that because the twists are always tied to the modes, but then only doubles ever happen, that it's something they're adjusting in the update. So what they need to do, hear me out. What they need to do is they need to just make doubles. Doubles is when you play with a partner and all of the people who go in and play with someone else always vote for that. Like, it's always constantly what you're playing. So what they need to do, they need to just make doubles its own mode, right? Let the people who want to play doubles go play doubles. Like, let them just join a lobby specifically for that. And then let the people who want to play not that join in a different one. I don't know. That might be crazy, but it's every single game. And then they all DC anyways. But that's exciting. I haven't played Roblox on the stream in so long. I gotta do that again sometime. I need to have another one of those. I did a stream one time, if anyone remembers, where probably the last time I played Roblox on stream was the stream where we played Race Around the World until I got a win. And actually, we did play one more round after I got a win. Because I promised someone they could play. They could be my teammate. And then we won the round before it was going to be them. And I was like, oops. But it was okay. It was fun. That was really fun, though. It was a lot of Race Around the World all back to back to back, though. That one can get exhausting. You've never finished a race with me? What do you mean? Have I DC'd? Or do you mean, like, we've never made it to the end. I don't know what you mean. Did we like Toxic DC one time? We dropped out for people? Oh. I didn't know that. But that'll be exciting. No, I've never... Have I ever done... I don't know if I've ever done Outlaster or Eviction Notice on stream. I feel like I've done Outlaster. Eviction Notice tends to be my least favorite of the ones. It was to play with Lisa. Well, can you blame me, Maple? Of course we're going to play with Lisa. Lisa's the icon. When are the Addisons going to be? So many people have been asking me this. When are the Addisons happening on stream? And my answer is I'm still not 100% sure, but I'm looking at dates. I'm eyeing up dates. I should hopefully have an answer to that very soon. I would say even the nominations aren't closed. No. But people are asked, you know, when am I going to present it on stream? And I haven't had an answer for that. I think I need one more week's worth of schedule for work. And then I think I can probably announce it. Like, I'm very close to ready to announce. It's just a matter... It's always hard because Kelly and Chase's birthdays are right then, too. And then you get into... what is it? Martin Luther King Day weekend, I want to say. That's the weekend of, like, the 11th, the 12th, all of that this year. So it's just hard, and with working now, I need to get, like, an exact... But stay tuned. The announcement should be out very, very soon. So... Look out for that. That'll be exciting. What else is going on with me? Still working. You guys, right now, Twitch has all kinds of deals going on through December. If you want, you know, it's a great time to give a little coin, a little Christmas present to the streamer. I think subs are like 25% off. Bits are like, if you cheer over, is it 300 or 500? It's either 300 or 500 at a single time. Twitch will add 10% to the bits. 300. It is 300. Kind of like I guess that's so people can't just do like 100, but 300 also. I mean, I'm not going to be mad that it's not 500, but... If ever you wanted to give some bits, if you give 300 or more at once, Twitch will add 10% to it. And that runs through, I want to say, the end of the year. Same thing with the subs, I want to say, that goes through the end of the year. I've seen someone cheer 1,500 and Twitch added 300. Oh. Well, that's not 10%. I may be wrong about the specifics. Well, let's look it up. What else do we have going on? Twitch bits incentive. Okay, here we go. Oh, wait. No, never mind. That's not right. Nope, that did not pull up December 2023. Bits bonus. Okay, here we go. Here we go. I found it. Okay. Okay, here's the full thing. There's a 25% discount on all new single and multi-month paid subs. So new. So I don't even think a resub applies to that. That might be wrong. Someone could correct me. But then that's the 13th to January 2nd. Then December 27th to the 2nd, so that last, like, week, any gift subs, single month gift subs, have a 25% discount. bits bonus from the 13th to the 20th. So we only have a week for that. If you want, I'm just saying, if you wanted to get in on that, we don't have much time. It's at least 10%. So I think maybe for more, it can go up. There might be a tiered structure or something. I don't know. And there's a newly themed hype train. I have not gotten any of the new hype train emotes, very sadly. I saw people using them, and I was like, what the hell is that? Because we've had the damn most recent set for, like, 2 years, is it? It's been so long. So I gotta find some hype trains and get them, because that's like a small window to earn them. I mean, I don't know how many there are. I mean, because usually it's five for level one, five for level 25 in total, five each for levels 1 through 5. And you can only earn one per hype train. So I don't know if it works that same way, if it's that same amount, because that's absurd. Maybe it's like one or two per level, but I don't know. Like, even a level 5 hype train is hard to come by. So, like, those are, I don't know, but... So, that's a thing. And again, that's limited time, too. So, you know, it's a great time if you want to throw a little dollar to streamer. It's a great time to do. What was I gonna say? I don't know. Do I have any other updates? Of course, I'm back to streaming. I'm going to try and be more regular. And then it's like, now it's Christmas. So I don't know what the schedule is going to look like. Tomorrow, though, we have a very fun stream tomorrow. I've hidden it. I did not want people to know. I've kept it a grave secret. But at long last, so you better all turn out because I'm very excited for this and I've been hyping it up. At very long last, tomorrow, I will be revealing my Apple Music replay. I know, but the good thing about it is it continues to update throughout the year. So, it will be updating again, because it updates on Sundays, it'll be updating again tomorrow. And then when it does that, I will be revealing live on stream my 100 songs. And let me tell you, should I give a tease? Let's give a tease. Now remember, this can change. Can you all agree on a number? 1 to 100? Well, no. 26 to 100. I'm not revealing anything in the top 25 at this time. Sorry, I have to keep those a secret. Pick a number. And I will reveal what song is at that. Right now, but again, it'll change tomorrow, because it is, that's the thing that Apple Music Replay has up on, 69, I knew you'd pick that. Do you know the level to which I knew that 69 would be picked as I already scrolled to that? I knew it was going to be 69, I was already right there. I can exclusively reveal that the number 69 song...
No.
Is. Treat Me Like a Slut, Kim Petras. How appropriate is that? Well. My thing is I imagine that most of this is like actually kind of like a tie, and it's just whatever order they're listening. Your 2022 top song. What was mine? Maybe I'll reveal you, because you know the other thing too is Apple has all your playlists from past years. I can go back to 2018. Let's see. Maybe I'll reveal my top 5 for each of those years. All right, number 5, 2018, number 5, Good as Hell by Lizzo. Number 4, No Tears Left to Cry by Ariana Grande. Number 3, I'd Rather Be Me from the Mean Girls musical. Number 2, Toy by Netta. And my number 1 most listened to song of 2018, La Forza by Alina Nechayeva from Europe. That was the opera Issa. you know the one from Estonia. 2019. Well, I would not have expected that. My number 5 most listened to song, Out Tonight from Rent the Movie. Number 4, Heavy Metal Lover by Lady Gaga. Number 3, Juice by Lizzo. Number 2, Show Yourself from Frozen 2. And my number 1 most listened to song of 2019, no surprise here, Spirit in the Sky by Kaino. I could have told you that. 2020, number 5, Spirit in the Sky by Kaino. Listen, it stuck around. Number 4, Higher Love by Kygo and Whitney Houston. Okay, interesting one. Number 3, Wuthering Heights by Kate Bush. A surprise to me that that made number 3. Number 2, Black Leather.
What is the Tia?
Tom, how are you, Tom? Thank you for resubscribing Tier 1 for 20 whole months, Tom. I can't believe it. Welcome back to Meerkat Manor. Tom, how are you? How was the wedding, y'all? Tom got married, and he looked so handsome in his tux. Was that a tux, or was it just a suit? It looked like a tux. It might have just been a suit. Get a little confused on what the difference is. Hi, JP. JP, how are you? Y'all, I had the lovely privilege of seeing JP in person recently at Santa Stuffed My Stocking, etc. A holiday Christmas cabaret production. JP, ooh, I hit puberty. JP, thank you for gifting a tier 1 sub to the community, getting the icon, the legend, Leo Unleashed there. And y'all, we've started a hype train. We were just talking about it. There are seasonal emotes available. If we can get that hype train past level 1, you didn't shave once and you hit puberty. I know, I need to shave. I'm just so lazy. That's honestly it. If that hype train gets up, then we got it. I want those damn Christmas emotes. I have... Oh my god, no. Oh, look. No, there's 5 emotes per level, and there's 5 levels. It's crazy. How do they expect anyone to do that within the Christmas season? It's not very long. That's absurd. Okay, I'm currently revealing my top 5 most listened to songs in the past years in preparation for tomorrow, when I will be revealing my top 100 most listened to songs of 2023. So we're in 2020 right now. We said number 5, Spirit in the Sky by Kaino. Number 4, Higher Love by Kygo and Whitney Houston. Number 3, Wuthering Heights by Kate Bush. Number 2, Black Leather by Kaino. And the number 1 most listened to song by me for a second year running was also my best song winner at the Addisons. So, keep that in mind. My most listened to song has a tendency to win best song. Just saying. React by the Pussycat Dolls. Every time I leave you. That's such a good song. And it got paid absolute dust because of the pandemic. But it was so good. At 2021. Okay. Number 5. Good For You, Olivia Rodrigo. Number 4. Faith, Bloody Faith by Jorn. Which was in Norway's national selection. I have to say, the reason it was that much is that it was very, very, very close to being my entrance song to the Addisons, to the point that I had tested it out, listened to it. So I'd listened to it a lot in the preparation for that, which is why that made it so high. Number 3, Venus by Kaino. A third consecutive year of Kaino. And number two. What's up with my voice? Am I going through puberty, like, live on stream? Number two, El Diablo, Elena Zagrinu. That was the winner for best song of 2021. The number one most listened to song, because I would listen to this after every workout. I should listen to it before as a pump-up song, but I didn't. I listened to it after. Was Adrenalina by Senhit featuring Flo Rida. Flo Rida? Oh my god, I'm so white. I'm... I did not just call that man Flo Rida. I'm so... Flo Rida with an A. Kira Stone flooded and ruined her garage during a performance of React. I love that. I love Kira Stone. What an icon. Flo Rida, cancel me. All right. Oh, interestingly, what won best song last year, Maple? Not the hard. Tom, stop! Oh my god, you're gonna get me canceled. Maple, you're a historian of the Addisons. What won best song last year? It was Alien Superstar, wasn't it? Wow, I'm not even seeing. Alien Superstar won best song in 2022 from. Oh, I have to count. Well, it's not going to tell me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. It was it won best song, but it was only my 18th most listened to song, so it's not a foolproof system. All right. 2022, top 5. You don't have the wiki up to date. Should I reveal the top 10? I should. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. Number 10. Number 10. Oh, we missed the train. We sadly will not be earning emotes at this time, but I thank you for the support. Number 10. Running Up That Hill, A Deal With God by Kate Bush. A song I love separately from Stranger Things, but it helped. Number 9, give that, no one, don't tell, no one tell Cindy, no one tell Steven, they go get all mad at me. Give That Wolf a Banana by Subwoofer. We don't need to talk about it. Wolfie Banana. Number 8, In Your Hands, which is from Grease. After I played Grease on stream, I became obsessed with the soundtrack and listened to it a lot, so that's how that made it. Number 8, Mr. Independent by Grant Gernoke, Texas's entry to American Song Contest. Number 6, Bigger Than the Whole Sky, Taylor Swift. Spoiler alert, who wants a spoiler alert? That will be in the top 100 of this year. Mm-hmm. Unless things change dramatically tomorrow, that's gonna make it. But it won't be my number one Taylor Swift song. I did say somewhere what my number one most listened to Taylor. I made a very big Taylor Swift fan guess what my number one Taylor Swift's most listened to Taylor Swift song of 2023 was. Because I said, you will never guess it. And they're like, what? Blah, 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 blah. And then guess what? They did not guess it because that shit was impossible. It's Carolina, which is the song she did for, Where the Crawdads Sing. And as soon as I told them, because they could not get it. Gotta think like out of the box, and they were not even getting close. Number 5, Run to the Hills by Clara Hammerstrom. Surprised me it's up that high, but also I'm very not surprised it's up that high because I did love that song and did listen to that song a lot. Tom, are you still here? Tom, just checking in. Ground control to Major Tom. Isn't that a song? Is that a song? Is that a song? That's a Bowie song. Look at me! Look at me. How many David Bowie songs can I name? That. Changes. Which I only would get because it's on the Shrek 2 soundtrack, except it's not his version, but he's, like, on it, but, like, doesn't... It's weird. Oh, I got the hiccups. No, I don't know any other David Bowie. Are there other David Bowie songs I should know? Under Pressure? Was David Bowie? Oh, Life on Mars. I should have got that. I should have got that. But I prefer, sue me, I prefer the Jessica Lange version. Oh, Fame. Oh, I did know that. I bet you I have Fame on my phone. I think Starman. I don't know that as a song. I know that's like an album. I bet you I have Fame by David Bowie on my phone. I do. Do I have any other David Bowie on my phone? No, just Fame. I don't know any of the... No, I haven't heard of the rest of these songs. Well, there you go. Oh, I forgot. I have to get the list back out. Sorry. Tom, I buzzed you because in at number 4, That's Rich by Brooke Scullion. Robbed G.Otis. Number 3, Hold Me Closer, Cornelia Jacobs. Number 2, Wonderland by Alexa from American Song Contest, the winner of American Song Contest, and my number 1 most listened to song. I'll give you a hint. It's from American Song Contest. Can anyone guess what state? What state song was my number 1 most listened to song last year? Was it New... Helios says, could it have been New Boot Goofin? It wasn't. Any other guesses? What country, what state or territory's song was my number 1 most listened to of last year? You can get this. I believe. Someone get this. Someone can get this. It's not hard. It's not a tough question. Oklahoma was Wonderland. New Hampshire, Maple, the correct answer is Fly by Mari Burrell from New Hampshire. How perfect is it that my state, my home state song was my favorite of American Song Contest? Like, I could have gotten some horse shit country song, but I didn't. I got a bop. 0% surprise. I mean, but if New Hampshire's song had been bad, I would have hated it. Right? But the one ever American Song Contest, I love New Hampshire's song. Like, what are the odds of that? And she ate that up when in her qualifier round, the juries put her like 9th, and so I didn't watch the next episode because I didn't want to see her go home. But then the televote saved her. Listen, she should have been in the finale over like half of those boring ass country songs. But it's okay because then Oklahoma won, and I believe Oklahoma won with a higher televote percentage, like of possible total score from the televote, than any song in Eurovision has ever gotten. I'm fairly certain. It got like It got like 98%. Like it got 12 points from every state except for like, it was like 4 or 5. Like, what a bop. What a bop. Like, truly deserve it. But, you know, what will be the top? What will make the top this year? And could it be an indication of what could win Best Song at the Addisons? I'm looking at the thing right now. I have actually... Does anyone know what my number one song is? I have said it. It could change. But I did... I have said one or two places what my number one song is. So, just saying. It is possible that some people already know that. Like, to give the big game away. What are we getting? When are we getting hot top picks? Addison goes through his Grindr history. Well, I enjoy not being banned on Twitch, contrary to what I tried to do that one time when I streamed the Olympics. Listen, I learned my lesson. So probably never. Probably never. You all, do you think JP could get nominated at the Addisons for Best Drag Performer? It's certainly possible. It's certainly possible. We'll just have to wait and see. Tune in on January. Should I leak it? Should I leak what I'm looking at? Okay, I'll just tell you. I'll just tell. Here, you know what? I'll give you the nominee. The nominees. Here's what I'll say. The nominees for what day I'm going to do the Addisons live on Twitch. The Addisons nomination presentation live on Twitch are Sunday, January 7th. Saturday, January 13th. Sunday, January 14th. These are your nominees for what day I'm going to do the Addison nominations live on Twitch. Lucy LaDuca will win. Well, I haven't seen Lucy LaDuca perform live in person this year, so could that hurt her chances? Question mark. Well, you know, I want to do it on a weekend. I'm sure that's not a surprise to anyone. I can't do it on the 6th. I'm working, and I would just like to have... I could do it after work, but I don't want to be, like, tired and stream. So I kind of want to just do it on a day I'm not working. So the Sundays are both strong options because I don't work on Sundays. And then... But I don't know if on the 7th we're going to be doing stuff for Kelly and Chase's birthdays are the next 2 days after that. So I don't know if you stream after work. Well, Saturdays is a short day. On a Saturday, I would get out of work at like 1:15. So like that's a lot more reasonable. What was I going to say? So I don't know if on the 7th we're doing something. And then you get to the 13th, and I don't know yet if I'll be working the 13th. I shouldn't, because I'm working the 6th, and you usually don't have multiple Saturdays in a row. But then that takes us to the 14th. So it will be, unless there's a surprise for me, it should be one of those days at least. So what you're saying is Amethyst will win. I've seen Amethyst perform. I've seen Amethyst perform live this year. Listen, that's one. I haven't done all my short lists, but I've done some. Maybe I'll leak a short list coming. Oh my god. Oh no, you can see that I'm wearing pajama pants. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I didn't feel like putting on real pants, so I'm wearing pajama pants. They have the Grinch on them. Oh, I almost just took out the green screen. Ooh, do we like them? My Grinch pajama pants. He gets kind of green screened out, but Which ones have I gone through? I went through and did some of the easier ones, because some of them are very long, and I have to go through, like, my full watch history, so I haven't shortlisted new TV series, but I can do that one pretty soon. I have shortlisted best podcast, long-listed, excuse me, this isn't the short list, this is the long list, best podcast. I listen to more podcasts than I think I do, because I was like, this won't be that long a list, and then suddenly that. Best supporting actor in a movie, anything to do with movies or TV I haven't done yet. Best video game I need to go in and do, haven't done that yet. Here's dually the lists for best drag I put these on one because I knew they'd both be a little shorter. Best drag performer is that through that. I could add more names, but I haven't yet. I could come up with some probably. And best board game is there. So there's best board game if I do bring that back, which I'm weighing back and forth. Not an analog list. Oh, I love a written out list for it. It just helps me. Here's best live event. I did best live event. Not so many on that. I didn't go to as much this year. There's movies and TV ones. Here's best album. Best album. Not that many on best album. But there never is. There never really is. Best album is the only category that has 8 nominees. Because it's just, there's not as many. And I need to give some other things a chance. Like, I haven't really listened to Sour. Like, I need to go and listen through, like, Sour. Is that what it's called? Guts? Oh, is it Guts? Is Guts the new one? I think Guts is the new one by Olivia Rodrigo. Tom sent me a list of some stuff. Helio sent in a few suggestions. Best musical artist. I've got best musical artist here. Formerly best singer, and then I changed it to best musical artist. That's a good list. Best celebrity, then, is the last one that I've done. Best celebrity has a lot on it. This is currently the list of best celebrity. Yes, it ran into a third column. Yes, I'm still working. Should I reveal some of the things on best celebrity? Give me a number between 16. Give me a number between 1 and 16, and I'll reveal the 3 people who are written out on that line. That's what I'll do. Give me a number between 1 and 16. One, Britney Spears, Kaya, Lauren Jaguari, or Jaguar. I don't know how to pronounce it. One more. Give me one more. Do one more. One more number. And don't just say 2. I mean, you can say 2, but, like, be creative. 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Olivia Colman, the Countess Luann Kino. I'll give you one more bonus. 1, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. Give me a number between 17 and 32. And then I'll reveal, because that's when we get down just into the 2s. I'll reveal one more set. But this will just be a double. And keep in mind, not all these people are going to be not 24. Okay. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Bryn Whitfield from The Real Housewives of New York and Amber Heard. And that's as much as you're getting. You'll have to tune into the Addisons on the 9th, the 3rd, the 9th? The 8th? What did I say? On the... that's December. On the 7th, the 13th, or the 14th. You'll have to tune in then to find out. But it's exciting. Yeah, I don't know. In some ways, it feels like I'm way behind where I should be. But also, last year, I set a very bad precedent where I essentially didn't start working on it at all until the week of. So the fact that I've even shortlisted some categories puts me ahead. But I also was unemployed last year. Which gave me, like, just a smidge more time to work on it. DJ, welcome in. How are you? Are you ready for some Lake? It's the finale. So actually having a job now means I have, like, notably much less time to work on the thing. It's the longest part. What's the longest part? The long list takes a while. The long list takes can take a bit. Especially for the, like, acting categories, because I have to go, like, show by show and get the... And that can take a bit. But the... What I always say is the longest part is getting the pictures of the nominees and putting that into the PowerPoint takes a while. You said the lake was ending last year. Well, I lied. It ended up taking a little longer, and I was so hungry I physically could not slake. I love your accent. Do I don't see myself as having an accent, but this is the, I was also, someone also commented on my accent last week, not on stream in person. And I was like, I think of myself as having like some pronunciations that I do differently, but those are often sometimes kind of conscious choices. What was I gonna say? Or I have a tendency to put the emphasis on weird syllables of words and phrases. And now I can't think of any, examples, but I'm sure you all have noticed there's times where you're like, oh, that's not really how most people say that. It's gay, it's housewife, it's Northeastern, maybe Italian, Bostonian. Well, I'm not Italian, so probably not. And I'm not really very, I mean, I'm Northeast. It's not very Boston. Now, when you hear like a Boston accent, you're like, ah, that like, I'm not like, I don't see myself as having an accent, but I don't see, I don't know. I don't see most Americans as having an accent. Some people certainly do, but I think there's sort of a... I don't know. Would I say Maple has an accent? No, he has some Canadianism, but Canadians pronounce some words weirdly. And he sort of has those, but even then, not that much. You know who's a Canadian who does not sound Canadian? You know who is? Probably if I had to pick the Canadian who does not sound Canadian. Don't Do It Adam. Don't Do It Adam does not sound Canadian at all to me. He has maybe like one or two words, but like, I also think that might be like the actoriness that probably got like trained out of him. That would be my guess is why Adam doesn't sound very Canadian. I think they probably, have you seen him in Canada? Yes. I have seen pictures of Adam in Canada. Yes. Y'all saw that twink taking back shots in the Senate? I messaged Twitchy Tactics. I said, Twitchy, what is going on? He didn't respond because he hates me. Are you sure it wasn't fake? The picture, the video. Because I saw the video and I was like, that don't look fake. Hi, Red's Cast. How are you? Honestly, respect to him, and the funniest part of all of it is that it was in Amy Klobuchar's seat. As if Amy Klobuchar's beef with Mayor Pete wasn't enough. Another homosexual is doing her wrong. In my head, I don't have an accident. Tom, I'm glad to hear that. Oh my god, you mean accent. Okay, I was like, I don't know what that means. Accent. Tom, I mean... Tom, of course you have an accent. You're literally Irish. You're Irish. Everyone in Ireland has an accent. Did you all hear the news? No, you didn't. Where would you have heard it? Only Tom knows. Leo! Hi, Leo! Leo, you got a gift sub and got that founder's badge. Fun fact, did you all know Leo was my first ever sub? I was running a smidge late to my affiliate stream, and he yelled at me because of it, because he was waiting to be my first sub. And I was late to the stream. That was back... That's how you know Leo's one of the OGs. That was back in the day. Oh my god. When I didn't have a camera, didn't have a microphone, I was streaming off my laptop. Wait, let me walk you through the whole setup. Let me walk you through the whole, because it was a lot. I would be sat on my bed, like cross-legged. My legs would be ungodly sore after streaming. I'd be sat on my leg, on my bed, cross-legged. In front of me would be my laptop. That would have the camera and the microphone. I, for the entire stream, would not be looking at camera. I would be looking behind it. Because then at the foot of my bed, put there, was my TV and my entire, like, elaborate setup of cables and wires leading into my PC and into my Switch or my Switch dock. And so I would be playing the Switch off of my TV. It'd be going to my laptop, and the camera quality, terrible. The audio quality, even worse. I would not be looking at the camera. I would be, every clip that I look at from then is like this, because I'm like up, so I'm like looking up, so they're all like this, and it's so bad. I'm like, oh my god, I look it down, I'm like, how far we've come. The bed streams were another time. And that's, I always say there's certain like touch points of like, if you remember this, if you know this reference, like, it's proof you're an OG of stream. One of them is the bed streams, absolutely. What else do I say? When I did my Masked Singer, like, reviews on stream, that was back in the day. Way, way back, I gave up this very quickly, was when I would do movie reviews. That's a throwback. There's other stuff that it's like, oh my god, never. The original set of emotes, never forget. Those are still around. Those are like the follower emotes now. But the OG emotes, oh my god, before I switched to the meerkats, that was a time and a half. And when was the last time you were in the Senate hearing room? Would you believe I've never been to DC? Oh, okay, they might be interspersed then. The OG emotes are these five. Those five, well, those were the first five that I, like, paid for and got. The original emotes, this is even further back. It was cheese, which we still have, and then two that I don't have in anymore, but I think it was one of Candace from Phineas and Ferb. And what was the third one? I think it was cheese, Candace, and maybe lips. Maybe, honestly, it was lips from the beginning. But I don't have Candace on here anymore. But why was Candace an emote? I don't know. Why was cheese an emote? Also, don't know. I don't really have an answer to that. I don't really have an answer to that question. But if you've ever wondered why there is an emote of cheese from Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, I guess that's not really a great answer. Because the answer is I don't know. But the actual answer is back before I bought emotes and I just wanted to upload something, that's there. Speaking of I don't have it, let me just upload something. That fucking sub badge that is my senior photo from high school. I just needed to upload something that was on my computer. I said, I'll just put this up for now as a placeholder. And it has been the ever since. I don't even know what to get as sub badges at this point. And it's like, it just feels like the ship sailed. Like, I don't know. Should we play Lake? Have I talked for long enough? Should we play Lake? Actually, we have to wait for DJ to get back. DJ went to get their groceries delivery. But yeah, Leah, I mean, you mentioned, have you seen the video? Have you guys seen the video? Good for her. Here's what I said when I heard about this and saw it, is I said, you were stupid to put those on social media. Now, I know it was on, like, their close friend's story, but still, it was stupid to put them on social media. And I don't think anybody's debating that. But my response is, you know what? Good for her. Good for her! But yeah, not great to put it on social media. But the Republicans, the conservatives, are lapping this up. So I'm like, I feel terrible for the person. Because I'm like, oh, you are in danger. Like, I don't know. But no, I was going to say something, but no, that's oversharing. I'm not going to say that. I have to draw the line somewhere. And in this instance, that's where it's going to be. Well, the bottom already got fired. Well, that's no surprise. It's hard to defend and come back from. I just hope they can, you know, I just hope they can get a job somewhere else. Such top privilege, though. Such top privilege that the bottom's getting all the punishment. And the top is like, we don't even know. We don't even know. We don't even care who the top is. Top privilege, if I have ever seen it in my life. It seemed like they already had an active Twitter before this whole thing, so it was only a matter of time. Well, there's nothing wrong with having a whole Twitter and being a woman of employment. It just is, you know, you have to keep in mind, you know, if you work for the government, I would say some anonymity may be of use. I'm just, and it's not to, you know, whatever. But I just think there can be a level of critical thinking around, like, cover your ass, basically. Cover your ass. I suppose in this instance that could really have more than one. Suppose in this instance that could mean two things. I don't mean it literally. I do mean it figuratively. Just watch yourself. Be careful. Don't get yourself in trouble. Right? And now, trouble. I've almost finished my drink. I don't know what that is. That looks to be a bit. Let me get the bit out. I don't know what that is. I'm sure it's edible, but I don't want to take that chance. Yeah. Mm. Time for another drink. Maple, I'm driving in a moment. The right is sharing pics at the bottom of them doing nothing. Just exactly. It's like, ugh. They gonna use that. Like, they needed any excuse. But, unfortunately, excuse has been provided. I am probably gonna go get another water. Just a water to have. Just for all the talking. And, again, I did say I do think I feel illness coming on. So, staying hydrated is gonna be important. So, I shall return in just a moment. don't miss me too much. But I'll be right back. I'm gonna hit stream ending soon. Y'all would have been like, excuse me?
Rise up, rise up. I'm a fighter, a survivor. Rise up, rise up. Lift up your head just like you're heaven bound. Spread your wings and fly. This is your moment to shine. Rise from the shadows. You are a warrior. Shout out your cries. Spread your wings. Rise up, fly.
Sorry, the song ended. It was just the end of the song, and Kelly stopped me. Shocking. Kelly has something to say. I'm crazy, but I feel so bad. Like, he doesn't deserve to not be disciplined, but he doesn't deserve the public naming and shame. Yeah, especially in such polarized times as these, it's like, obviously he fucked up. I don't think he's under any impression that he didn't, you know, make a mistake. But I'm not a big, like, life, like, we need to, this person needs to have their entire life ruined and destroyed. You know? We'll add another ad break. Two ad breaks before we even start the game. It's a wonder I didn't finish the Lake DLC in one stream last stream. I don't know why that could have been. What possibly? If only there was something that I could point to and say, Addison, this is probably why. It's very hot in my room. Let me turn on my fan. Okay. All right, let me get it all booted up. We're gonna start. Oh, does the top also work for the government? I was wondering how he got in. I guess that makes sense if he also works for the government. I hadn't even been a question in my mind. Well, actually it had, but I'd figured, I was like, huh, I didn't realize random employees could get, like, yes, I've heard the top is a Republican. Well, if ever there was something to deserve to be fired for. Excuse me. Who said that? Also a staffer. Oh, Leo's got all the tea. Leo knows. Well, listen. I didn't say that. You didn't hear that. Okay. All right. Let me make sure everything is good. Yes, I think we're good. Okay. All right, let's go. Oh my god, I booted the fucking DVD. Kind of like it's what was already open on my Steam because they're doing like daily login rewards, so I done mine earlier today. I And so it was just up on the screen, so I just like absentmindedly hit play. Not my best work. I have nothing to say. Oh god, I always forgot how loud the boot is. It's like, was it Danganronpa 2 that the like boot lobby music was like deafeningly loud? We continue. Here we go. Lake, everybody. Last time on Lake Season's Greetings, we were delivering the mail. I don't really remember where we left off. Did we make it past Christmas? We must have. I tweeted something violent and hypothetical about a judge who was evicting people during the COVID moratorium in May 2020. Someone reported it to my workplace and my work tried to punish me for it. Thankfully, I'm unionized. Oh, we are delivering the mail. Oh, no, that's right. We got given like a special. We're doing like a special. That's right. No, there was something. Because I was like, it's a Sunday. Oh, fuck. It's a Sunday. I went private on Twitter for a bit because I was applying and like getting my like in the process of potentially I figured it wasn't gonna work out, but I didn't want to take any chances to work on Big Brother, and I was like, okay, I gotta private my Twitter so they can't look up and see any of my tweets. A foxy. I love all the animals they added to this. Like, I love that. Although it scared the shit out of me the first time one popped out in front of the truck and I had to, like, slam on the brakes. It really, like, when it's, like, snowy and stuff like this, it's so beautiful. I wish there was a way for it to be, like, the, like, you know, beautiful snowiness without the cold. Right? You know what I mean? Because I can't stand... I would have no issue with, like, snow and stuff if it wasn't wet and cold. If it just, like, existed, that would be okay. But it's so... Like, it's unpleasant. Enjoying being a daddy? It's different. I do miss Meredith. I thought she would be, like, in the game. So it's kind of weird to not have her in the game at all. You know what I mean? I mean, she's in it in voice form, but it's weird that, like, she physically hasn't made any appearances, which is just, it's weird. But I guess it was inevitable because it is part of the plot of the game, the base game, that, like, she hasn't been back in, you know, however long. So I suppose... I suppose it makes sense. Oh, Christ! Why did they stop there? That's not a stop. But they're like, this is from someone in the community. No, babe, this is from someone in the US, most likely with Canadian. What do you mean, brand image? Oh! Meeting Angie was so odd. Like, I'm a D-slur. Like, yeah, I knew that, sweetie. Oh, yeah. That whole conversation, I was like, there are no good... Oh, wait, I don't remember what I'm doing. And I guess I don't need to pick something up. I thought I was delivering something. Maybe I'm picking something up. Oh, hi, Matt.
Special delivery. Movies from the Flick Shack.
Right. Well, great news. You get to play belated Santa yourself.
Room 6 for Richter.
Thank you.
Right.
Episode, I hate him. I have, like, a weird love in my heart for Matt Kearney. I don't know what it is. I enjoy him. Like, for no good reason. Like, he's a douche, but there's something that I'm just like, question, are you messy? Like, in what sense?
Movie delivery for Connor Price Wrangler Ilsa Richter.
Yes?
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Price. I thought this was Ilsa's room.
No, that's room 9, but think nothing of it, my guy. Ooh, you got me my Bond movie.
Absolutely. The spy action thriller you asked for.
Love it. You know, Moore's an even better 007 than Connery. He just...
Which, you know, I've never seen a... Did we talk about this last stream?
Thank you so much.
I've never seen a James Bond movie. I don't really have a strong desire to. Maybe if there was like a Lady Bond, I'd be more interested, but I just don't. I don't really watch many action movies. You know, it was a good spy movie? Spy, starring Melissa McCarthy. That's a good spy movie.
Yay. Good to see you, Thomas. So, what movie did you and Angie pick for me?
Give me a gay Bond. A gay Bond will make all the sex make sense.
Haven't seen this one. What's it about? Tennis?
Richard Madden. There you go. There's your Bond.
Good one. Not about tennis, but it's
I couldn't think of his
ace.
Name for the life of me.
Ha ha. I'm sure it is. Looking forward to it. Let me guess. This was Angie's pick.
Well, let's just say it was a group effort.
Okay. Well, color
didn't
me
Daniel
curious.
Craig dabble? How would I know? He didn't dabble with me.
Dogs. Oh, speaking of, on your way out, could you give a quick knock on Gabe's door? Just so he'll know it's movie time. It's room number 2.
Will do.
Great.
The
See
she's
ya.
Fat and ugly jokes at Spy were kind of repetitive. I mean, I guess I haven't seen it in a while, but I did think it was very funny. Who, what, it's who's the lady? Rose Byrne. Rose Byrne was fantastic. And Jude Law is so handsome.
It's movie time,
Richard Madden,
Gabe.
Yes, he makes such a good
room number 9.
Gay Bond. He won't admit he's gay, but he is.
Thanks, Thomas. I'll be right over.
He's been cited with one too many little Twinkie Twunks to not be. I will say, though, I'm glad that...
Okay, Ben. Question for you. You have that ace or not?
So, Froy
you don't have to say
was
yes or no,
dating Richard Madden.
Say anything.
But they broke up, and now Froy is dating Zane Phillips, and it's nice because it's like, oh, he'll actually post him, right? That was the whole thing.
Twitch or a blink? All right, I'll do the talking. I'm all in.
Call.
And he just instantly calls me. Great. I don't even need to see your hand. Well played, sir.
Thanks, Jack. You got unlucky there.
I don't know. I just don't have the patience for poker. Reading a poker book ain't gonna change that.
A former CIA Thomas? Agent who is cleared for public media has done interviews with Wired, and she basically said every agent is fat and ugly. We pick the most common people possible. Hot people are always noticed. True, but you like to think of a spy as being a hot person, right? Like, there's just something that's, like, pleasing about, like, it's the Bond thing. Like, Bond is this, like, suave, handsome, and so, like, that's the picture you have in your head.
Oh, I don't know. Just feels more cozy, I guess.
Thomas, we don't need to keep this a secret. Walter Morgan's on my tail.
Someone snitched on me, and now I need to lay low until I have a good enough alibi.
Morgan again? What'd you do, Frank?
Frank?
You didn't put ladies underwear in his briefcase again.
And please tell
Frank
me stop putting dead
probably
in
should be fired.
The classics. No, I didn't prank him at all this time. He's just out to get me. All I did was
Walter Morgan is drunk. Listen.
He said something about that being my
watch it.
Third strike. I might actually lose my job, fellas.
Like,
we won't let that happen, Frank.
I don't know.
We'll think of
Frank does a lot of stuff he's not supposed to. It's like
come up with anything.
He probably should be. If I should be fired, like.
Just that there's a guy fitting my description. What are you getting at?
I don't know.
But let's first play a few more hands. I'm down almost $30.
One sec, Jack.
Don't deny it. Walter's too hot for this game. The stash, the glasses, the voice.
We know Walter
Morgan. He doesn't do it for me.
Why do you dislike him?
He doesn't do it for me. Walter Morgan, I don't know.
I can tell you why, but it's not a pretty tale. And it better not leave this room. Kitchen.
A kitchen is a room.
Frank.
My lips are sealed, for once.
Who's Jack? Jack's the farmer? I think so. It is that poor Tom. His favorite character's not even in this game. I bet they couldn't get the voice actor to come back. Because why else would they just be like, eh, he's away?
All right. So this one time back in the summer of 69...
Are you a fan of the Eagle? I've never been. I've told Harry, Buff Boy Games, who went and had a fun time. I've said, okay, when I come to New York,
you
have to take me.
Eating a sandwich or whatever. Can't blame them, huh? They were hungry, even though I fed them every now and then. Morgan found out, of course, and after one complaint too many,
I would. Yeah, I just have never.
Or should I say?
Been in New York when it was sort of a situation to do it.
And before I knew what was going on, it was too late. I heard a loud and gut-wrenching howl. I saw two dogs run away, and Smokey, my favorite one, limped out.
My God, Walter Morgan, dog abuser? That's hot. That's dark.
Walter Morgan looked me straight in the eye with a smug grin on his face.
That's very dark. I wasn't expecting that.
This is how you do a proper job, Frank. I can still see that grin when I close my eyes.
Okay. That does it. Walter Morgan is now on my attention.
You definitely have the vibe
list.
Of appearing innocent but being
sure
the kind of sinner that would have the most
fit
ego, you know? I have nothing to say to that.
Walter freaking Morgan. Your pranks were way too soft, Frank. We need to take it to the next level.
What a despicable
I have no comment at this time.
I can't believe he did that.
Well... He didn't. I was joking, of course. I don't really have a good reason for disliking Walter Morgan. That boring old pencil pusher just rubs me the wrong way.
Damn it, Frank, you had us good.
Okay, folks. Ante up. Here we go again.
He tricked me. You had us fooled. How dare you, Mrs. Spears? And you too, Mrs. Spears. Death
Thomas,
to all of them.
Here.
Hey, Frank.
What the fuck is going on?
What are you
what is,
doing?
There? I can't with Frank.
I'm trying to stay out of sight. Looks like Morgan will be at the post office all day. Listen up. Jack and I cooked up a little plan. I'm sure Morgan will be gone soon. But I gotta get out of here now. You haven't seen me.
Frank is committing federal crimes like his dad. Like, Frank, do not give a shit. And I'm like, I don't know that I support you on there.
Top of the month.
All right, what are we looking at? Anything on the outskirts? No, actually, today will be... This
hey,
will
morning,
be quick.
Theo. We're starting this week with a warning from Lucinda.
A warning?
Theo, positive or pet peeves?
Hi, Jack. KNW6TV...
Which way do I turn?
Left. Gross filming in P.O. yesterday with Connor Bryce. As a big fan, I just had to ask him for an autograph. He asked me for my name, but he kept calling me Linda.
Linda!
Even after I corrected him twice. Isn't that just rude?
Well, that's a bit rude indeed, Linda. I mean, Lucinda, of course. Sorry about that. The weather prediction for today, bright but chilly. Enjoy your day.
Oops, I rolled the truck. I was curious if it would let you drive across the ice. I mean, I figured probably no, but then I flipped the truck. Oh, this is, which one is the, God, it really is a short play. This is, Stop Right Here. It's not that many songs. You learn which one is which pretty quickly. The people who made the game know about it, though, because when I read the, like, announcement of the DLC, whatever it was, they commented on, like, a few more songs, but not too many. So, it's, to my understanding, that that's, like, a recurring thing about this game that, like, everyone's aware of. It's like, there is not a long playlist. All right. I think we probably only have today and tomorrow left. I might have to come up with something else to do after Lake as well, because I think we're going to finish it, and we're going to finish it not particularly long into.
Hi there, ladies.
Hi, Thomas.
Hello, that's Thomas. Our friend who's moving. Right.
Got a delivery.
It was like,
for the diner.
Sad. I don't remember her.
Great. Not from the general store, I see.
You tell me. All the information I usually need is on the address label.
Oh well. Okay, so before I leave, we had this awesome girls' night yesterday, thanks to Beth. It was hilarious. When I first saw where we were going, my brain went, oh my god.
Well, where'd they go?
When they showed us what we were going to do, my brain went, oh my god. And when we started, it was so yuck, but also so cool, you know? I've never done anything like that before, and I love that I got a chance to find out. But then again, I doubt that I
What did they
it.
Do?
Ah, yes, the girls' night. What did you end up doing?
We made haggis.
Haggis is nasty. I've never had it, and
was.
I don't want to.
I said haggis. It's a Scottish dish made from a sheep's liver, lungs, heart, and suet, all stuffed into a sheep's stomach. It's this fascinating traditional gourmet staple.
The Scots need
the
to be
15th
studied.
Century.
What?
You believe? Poems.
You'd never heard what it is before?
Ugh, that sounds disgusting. I'm glad we mostly had processed foods at poker night.
The Scots
well,
need
I
to be.
Say, Thomas,
we need to figure out what's going on up
Philistine.
There.
It was so gross.